And before we go into prayer, so that we can pray together as a family, we will ask everyone to introduce themselves and then we'll go into prayer. I'm Elaine Allen Bradley and I'm chair for the DAC.
Hello, I'm Pedro Lee from Negril, I'm a member of the DAC.
Lionel Mayor, Destiny Chapman.
For the government, it's not really me, Ibi.
John Pettigrew, the group.
And I'm also the chairman of the Negril CDC.
This time I will discuss my policy vision.
Negril Western, co-primary vice chair.
John Marshall, the cousin Stowe.
This is your right, Tracy, actual.
This is my daughter, Hanover Municipal Corporation. This is my daughter, Hanover Municipal
Corporation. This is my daughter, Hanover Municipal Corporation.
Of Anthony Lewis, German doctor by nationwide.
Barry Howe, Negril Travel Guide, Negril Chamber of Commerce.
Sharon Williams, Public Relations Officer, National Assembly.
Ellen, you
are the president.
Thank you very much for coming. Can we have somebody to lead us in prayer, please? Volunteer.
I'll do it.
Thank you.
Father, in Jesus' name, we come to you. We ask that you bless this group. We ask that you move with your Holy Spirit amongst us and bring some unity and some power to help make things happen. We thank you for this opportunity to come together. In Jesus' name, amen.
Thank you, Mary. Once again, welcome. Apologies for absence, Mr. Daniel Grizzle, from Chairman. President of the Chamber of Commerce for Negril. Any other apologies for absent?
Apologies for Mr. Penda.
And also apologies for Christine Cohen, who is off island. And Mr. Nelson, who is also off island.
Mr. Morris.
And Mr. Morris.
Mia Moore.
Paul.
Ms. Laura Wallace. Or the hospital carry. Dr. Steer. Mr. Steer is quite simple.
Thank you very much.
Dr. Harvey, off the island. Lois McCampbell Simmons, off the island.
Thank you. Anybody else? Any more apologies? I must thank Mr. Mary and Mr. Tola for getting this venue for us. At our last meeting, public meeting in Negril, the residents of Lucea asked that we bring the meeting to Lucea. So here we are, and we hope that we'll have a very productive and fruitful meeting with things happening. And so we are here to enlighten the people of Lucea that, as they said when they come to Negril, that they seem to be forgotten. How can we forget them when every tourist pass through Lucea? So here we are, and I hope for the betterment and development of Lucea, we will be able to sort out some business. So has everybody read the minutes? If you haven't, I'm not going to give time to read the minutes. I think they were sent, by email. So, and what I ask, please, is if the minutes are sent by email, people could read them in advance and then highlight the points that they want to discuss. And then that will help to move the meeting forward in a nice manner. As we are in Lucea, we will not go through the minutes line by line. We will just deal with all the matters pertaining to Lucea. Firstly, I must say, if you look in the minutes, you will see there is some beautification that we have for Lucy. Mr. Myrie will sort of fill us in after we ask Mr. Gordon from the SWMA to highlight the garbage problem that we have in Lucy, how he is going to make it more effective, or try to make it more effective, because he has to rush. So, Mr. Gordon, please.
Thank you very much, Lynn. Good afternoon, everyone. I hope you can forgive a garbage man for interrupting what would otherwise be a clean meeting. Suffice it to say that we all generate solid waste, and though we don't like it, we don't like to see it around, there's a lot that we can do to reduce it. I am reading the minutes of your last meeting, and I saw 15 notes read the LSWM, and I was very happy when, in introducing me, I was asked to give highlights, and therefore I will not attempt to go line by line in the base of the 15 notes. I want to say right up front that we are well aware of the challenges right across Jamaica with our less than efficient service. Some people say I'm stupid to accept that right up front. And I accept up front because this group is a very responsible group, and I have to therefore take into my confidence, acknowledging the character of this meeting, and give the truth. We actually need 100 new trucks at the LSWM. We are fortunate last year to have been given 28. Now, we are more than thankful for the 28 trucks. But 28 out of 100 still leave us 72 behind. We are now operating in a very aged fleet. There are times when we do repairs only for you did something on the front end, and by the time the truck goes, the hour after the driver comes, or something on the back. And why I make this point is because it is easy to do the criticism, and we don't for 1 minute take any criticism lightly. We believe that we are servants of the public. We believe that we spend taxpayers' money and ought to be held to a very high standard. So we won't quarrel with the consumer. We take all criticism on board and we treat them seriously. We see how we can address it. But there are some realities that the consumer need to know. One is that with the very aged fleet, and yes, our fleets, our trucks get aged more than the regular trucks that we see around, because in garbage collection, our engines are not off. We always run it up, then it will go around the truck. For example, a truck will be doing 2 trips out of Westmore and carrying garbage all the way to the land, 50 miles. And we try to squeeze 2 trips out of it. Now, somebody say, what is 50 miles? Guess what? It has to drive around with the engine on, even it stop to load right through. So it's non-stop wear and tear on what we do. And again, I say, it's a very aged fleet. So we do have mechanical problems, sometimes quite frequently. and that hamper our service. The other thing that hampers the service is traffic. All of us can understand that when you used to move from point A to point B, it would have taken you X time. It is taking you 2X long. The same thing happened in Hanover. 3X. Everywhere in Jamaica now is traffic jam. Some of the rural areas, the downstown, little Dallas, Planet Waverly, everywhere you encounter traffic. And that, just like it slows down the regular commuter, it slows down the truck. Now, if we are already short on trucks, and then we can't move as fast as we want to move because of the traffic, you understand that our problems are compounded. But more, a lot of people, hopefully not in this room, don't properly containerize their garbage. So our men, when they reach certain gates, they have to spend 10, 15 minutes scraping up, breaking up, bagging up, packing up before they move. So a community that would normally take us an hour, no, a community that would normally take us 15, 20 minutes to rip through if we had just picked up and leave. We are now spending an hour in those communities. Why? Because people refuse to properly containerize their garbage. So I ask the stakeholders here to help to push the message of proper containerization of the garbage. So I don't have to have a crew stopping at a gate with rake, broom, shovel, bags, and packing up for you. Because that slows me down even more. Plus it's hard on the crew. They are the lowest paid around now. The job is already a very uncomfortable one. They live in garbage. When we give them extra work by the company containerizing, it's bordering on even. So I ask that they help with this message of containerization. Then there are some cultural defects that we have to accept. Some of our people just not prepared to play their part in the Clean Jamaica project. I've seen people, I'm in New Kingston, I'm on Oxford Boulevard, and I've seen a nice SUV and a patty bag and a juice box just thrown through the window. Now that's right on Main Street. Now they need more Main Street than that. But I'm told that I'm not supposed to call it people nasty, I'm sorry with them, so I must say that. But I still try to find the correct pattern. To describe that. But we have that. Some people don't care. And they will throw things anywhere. Those skips that we see on the main roads that are filled up, most of them are not filled by the community people that they're supposed to serve. They are filled by business people who refuse to sign up a little contract to get their garbage properly to transported to the disposal site. So in a bid to avoid that little contract fee, they put the thing in a pickup or a car trunk and they pull this in the skip. Then you have some people who believe in basketball. What I mean here is that they don't want place in the skip. They throw it in the skip. If it fall into the skip, fine. If it drop beside the skip, fine also. They are on their way. Those are realities that we deal with. And so we are trying to work within the context of the cultural defect and the resource constraint to deliver the best we can with what we have. But we are doing more. We are looking at how we can build out a more efficient solid waste management apparatus in Jamaica. That going forward, some of these challenges we will have. And so we are looking at putting in 3 transfer stations. One in Westmoreland, one in Clarendon, one in Trelawney. The one in Trelawney, we have already started the prep work for it. We identified the location. We have gotten the support of the different agencies. We have gone overseas to look at examples of transfer station that could suit our local. And we will be erecting that transfer station beginning in this budget year because we got funding to start it and hopefully go as far as possible. If we are not able to complete it in this cycle, then we have to complete it in the next cycle. Now, what are transfer stations? Transfer stations are temporary storage facilities where we house the garbage temporarily in a controlled space and then transport it by large bins to the disposal site, thus preventing the wear and tear on our units, freeing up units to go back into the community quicker. So if a transfer station was in Westmoreland, for example, that transfer station would allow the truck that would be otherwise in traffic traveling 50 miles to retirement and maybe only able to give you one trip per day. That same truck could rush out to the transfer station and be back in the community and maybe give you four trips for the day. So what we will have is a cleaner environment overall. And then we would need so much trucks in Westmoreland because we have been that one truck doing far more in the same parish. So it, in terms of costs, we have done the numbers and we will be coming out with significant savings once the transfer stations are up and running. But it's more, it will also benefit to the environment because instead of having 7-8 trucks making trips to and from, spitting out all sorts of bad carbon into the air, to and from, one bin would be moving what the 4 or 5 or 6 trips, depending on the character of the garbage. One bin would move 6 trips, 7 trips of garbage. So we would cut the amount of negative for the environment. I'm very excited about the transfer station because we have right now a geographical challenge where our disposal sites are few and far between. So when we collect, for example, we collect solid waste in Trelawney, anything in the south of Trelawney, the south, southern Trelawney, we carry it all the way to Mandeville to dispose of it. In Clarendon, for example, when we collect garbage at Longville Park, which is on the border of St. Catherine and we have to carry that all the way to Riverton in Kingston. The other Clarendon, areas of Clarendon, we take it over to Mandeville. So you can understand why we break up huge transportation costs and we have to fix it truck every day and up and up and all that. With a project that is first from start. You know. So the transfer station, we believe, will be a major game changer. We believe it will revolutionize the way we manage solid waste in this country. And all of us at NSWM are very excited about the prospect of this coming on stream. So we are now looking also to do a massive public education program in the deep rural areas as it relates to composting. 70% of what we collect on a truck and drive 50 miles to a disposal site is composted and could be used back in your farms, in your garden, and all that. So we're going to do a massive public education program on that. And we believe that if we could get the culture of composting going, that would significantly cut our costs and will free up even more trucks. So we're not just complaining and we're trying new things, we are looking at best practices else in other jurisdiction and seeking to see how we can incorporate them here in Jamaica. I know that we have challenges in the western area in terms of Lucy. We met with the mayor this morning, we look at the town, we look at Sandy Bay, we look at Oakwell. And so far, so good. We have put enough in place to cauterize whatever problems there were, notwithstanding the truck issues that we have. and we are not looking as badly as we could have based on the problem we have. Are we where we want to be? No. But I'm sure that all efforts are being made to ensure that we do as best we can with what we have. We continue the dialogue, we want the dialogue, and so I ask you, please, don't hesitate. The chair is there, Mr. Edmund sits to the back of the room. And he has two phone numbers, so if when you ask for any number, I'll give you one, ask him for the other one too. And he is supposed to answer you when you call, and he's supposed to make every effort to ensure that your concerns are addressed. I say this now. One instruction, but that's very important. I say this with the greatest of sincerity, that if you call, because I know I get the complaint, I can't get it. And I'm the last one to defend a public servant if they are not doing their job. But there's no guarantee that you will get somebody the first time you call. Because I'm getting the same meeting. When you have to be here in Lucy addressing this honorable gathering, I can't get on the phone now. So leave a little message, and I'm sure he'll get back. We also have another number at the office that I can call. You wanted to share that you just want to tell us the number on the Facebook and everything. Real quick.
953-6282 or 6281.
The local number for WPM is 953-6281 or 6282. What about Facebook? These people are big people, have a smartphone.
WPM Waste. So that's at WPM Waste.
WPM Waste.
That's it,
okay. All right. And you can go on that and you can see schedule doing. You see we do a little scheduling, and sometimes we even miss the schedule and we miss it. We are careful enough to put on the same page that we miss the schedule, but look across the following day, and we sometimes give a little reason to as to why we miss the schedule. We're in this thing together, and I know traffic is very important. Everybody gets excited, they don't want the garbage around and everything. And I understand that because I don't want the garbage at my gate either. But I ask you to understand that we have some challenges. We are working through them. And in the current context, we are working as hard as possible, doing the best we can with what we have. Are there any questions? Yes, sir.
Randall Fosse, Negril CDC. I've heard you outline the plans for the future, right? And I've also heard you say that you're working with an aged fleet. But I haven't heard you say anything about the mechanics to maintain the aged fleet.
Very good.
Or even the new fleet that's coming in.
Very good. So the new trucks won't run into the same problems like the old trucks, because all the new trucks, we have we have a service contract with the dealer. So that's in place. But let me answer the other side of the question. We want to get out of the garage business. I don't think governments do a good job with any garage. So I am talking to truckers, and yesterday I had an international delegation. We are talking to different organizations. And they are making some proposals, very exciting proposals for us. One of them is to give us the 100 trucks and the money that we use to fix truck and to pay for truck and all of that, we pay them the installments. And when they give us the 100 trucks, they will be prepared as needed to service. Do everything. We have nothing to do with the truck apart from drive them, wash them off, and if there's a light bulb to change, the dealer comes in. So we have those conversations going. Because like you, we are very concerned that we are bogged down too much in this truck argument. Truck is our main problem. Every time you see a problem with garbage, if we had the truck, we would have no problem. Because we would much rather be here today taking some congratulations. So, gentlemen, we are behind the camera, you have said you have said you. Okay, I thought you had.
You mentioned about commercial garbage,
yes.
And people are not actually paying or want to pay, or rather drive and put it
in the city.
Now, have there been any fines for these commercial entities who are doing this? May everybody know the commercial basis. And I think the NSWMA should put some heavy fines on commercial entities who have not got a contract. How many times have you served a summons on someone who has not got a contract for their garbage?
Right. We have done a number of prosecutions for people who when we catch them done being illegal. And some of them are business people. Because recently, as 2 months ago, a major project going on in Kingston with intercept trucks taking refuse from that site. To go there and we're gonna alert citizens that gave us the call and we were able to. So we do prosecute. The truth is that the fines are not as you are doing. And that is being worked on, and the ministers assured us that the fines, the increased fines, I think they're coming now, so we'll soon be enjoying increased fines. A critical piece of regulation that is required is being worked on now. Because really and truly, unless I catch you doing an illegal, I can't do anything. We want to take it further. We want to put the burden on that business owner to prove to us that they have proper arrangement in place for their garbage collection. And pretty much like the GCT certificate that is put up in your business place. We want to see, we want to register, you have something, you are running an establishment, you're generating tons of garbage, we want to see something over there that says that you are compliant. That's where we want it to go. And with those kind of muscle, then we will have a better, in my view, a better operation going. But to address your point, we have been possible when we catch.
That you should have ground officers that go to every business place, or when a business place is registered, they need to show that they have a certificate for proper disposal of their garbage. Don't you think that should happen before they grant them license?
No, I answered. That's where the regulations comes in to get people, to force them, to the burden on them, to prove that. Right? But I can't just pull up an emotion. I have to be backed by the regulations. But I agree with you. I agree with you, that's exactly where we want to go. There are right costumes. And I'm not going to speak to any particular ethnic group. But I'm sure most people know who I'm talking. They're giving us help right across the room. But that's what they did. This habit has catch fire right across the country, you know, where people just give a little crap head the garbage to go and dispose of. Don't care where they want to go, they just move it from their place, and so on. And we have, in the past, we have searched through garbage and found evidence and have prosecuted it. We have a serious challenge though, in it. We don't have enough enforcement officers. And the truth is, where we do have, for example, we have in Montego Bay, four, and they don't have a vehicle. So you understand our challenge. But we have to, there are some things which are just not members not able to respond the way we would love to because we don't have the equipment and the boots on the ground. All those are in the, we have done all the work for them, how much officers we would need, vehicles that we would need, everything. But you know, we operate within a budgetary constraint that we have no control over. We just have to see how we can get the improved garbage collections going from the compliance end in terms of your public education, getting people to cover the containerized. We have now had some funding in place to build the one transfer station. We believe that by the time that one is built and start working on people see the benefits of it, the other three, the other two, will come and stream shortly thereafter. Let us do those levels that we can now and then look towards improving the going forward.
So. I for one must say that I think you're going in exactly the right direction. And I think you ought to be applauded for what you've done since you've been in the job. I'm pleased to hear of all the things that are going on. It's a very dirty business, as we know far better than I. And it does need cleaning up, and I mean those funds as well. But I would say to you, things like, for example, enforcement, I would have thought the best thing you could do with that was to put it out to a private security company, to farm it out. Don't even attempt to do it yourself, because we all know what happens with stakeholders and greenhouse problems like that. It doesn't get enforced. It doesn't get enforced by municipal corporations, and it doesn't get enforced by anybody else, because people get into the job and they get too familiar with it. But the other thing I wanted to say to you was on the transfer station, that is the only way to do it. I've traveled quite a lot in the world in different places, and I can say to you that is the only way you can cover it. So all power to your elbow on that one. I lived in Spain 20 years ago, and just recently I asked a friend of mine who still lives there what the collection was like of garbage. 6 nights a week, this is in rural Spain, 6 nights a week, the garbage is collected. If you leave garden rubbish out by your front gate or by close to your house, it will disappear within 2 or 3 days. And if you've got anything bulky, like an old fridge, and let's face it, we suffer a lot, awful lot from most of the things, then what you do is you make a phone call and they will tell you what night they're coming to collect it, and it's gone. You know the cost of that? The cost of that is 280 euros per year. You can pay that in 2 installments. And that's still the case today. And that was going on 20 years ago when I was there, when Spain was a third world country, so. And that's where we want to get to. And the last phone call I'd like to make is, and I'm going to quote from this before I finish it. Hanover is always among the top parishes with respect to its compliance rate annually for tax purposes. Now, Hanover right now, sir, is not getting the service that it needs from NSWMA. And I understand we've got a problem in Hanover with trucks. There aren't enough trucks to go around. I also would say to you that a friend of mine who was travelling to the airport the other day said she saw a number of trucks driving down the road with garbage in them, but there was no cover over the truck and it was blowing everywhere. Now, surely, they should be netted or a tarpaulin put over the top. I can understand the problem with transport. I was in transport myself. But little things like that mean a lot. And we really do need to get on top of it. It's no good having the people paying their taxes if all they're going to get is nothing. And that's what's happening.
Well, first, let me thank you very, very kindly, sir. Appreciate it. Very, very.
You're doing a good job.
Thanks. The trucks with the open back trucks, those are tippers. We rarely use those except in special operations. So, that we use compactors. So, you are correct. That when we do use tippers, we should cover the we don't want to be making dust nuisance or creating garbage pollution when we try to clean up and save that. So maybe those trucks were out, but nonetheless, I've taken on. With regards to privatizing the enforcement, that would require adjustment in the law because the law guides us as to how we operate on enforcement. Something worth looking at, and I take it as a genuine concern and something that we will look at. With regards to Hanover and its property tax payment, I know that Hanover usually does well with the payment of the taxes, and they would naturally deserve to be treated better. However, when I met with the mayor this morning, he was of the view that notwithstanding the challenges, that he would have seen the efforts, and in the main, he thinks that he wouldn't want to be overly harsh because he don't think it's at the stage we would be overly harsh. Now, I say this to say that I did some driving around this morning myself, and I was reasonably comforted. I would ask you, therefore, if there are areas that you want to tell me about, because I couldn't go everywhere in a short visit, that you want to tell me about, and I would be only too happy to see what interventions we can make in those areas, even within the context of all the challenges that I've outlined.
Okay, well, I'll give you one straight away, mate. And that is outside the resident magistrate's court, which always looks as if it's a bomb site.
Yes.
I know what's happening there. People are dumping commercial waste there as well overnight.
Commercial?
Yes. But that's not the only thing. Everybody from the country is bringing their bags into town when they go to work and they're throwing them in there.
So we probably go up to the
I've only seen that thing once, and that was really bad. Only once, and I've lived here for 14 years. I've only ever seen that thing once, and it was over there. So somebody's doing the right thing now and again. But I could mention other places, I'm not going to because I've been.
We will plug that. We will plug that, and we will ensure that special attention is given. Brian Watson?
Yes, thank you, sir, for the question. But the area gentleman speaks about is just beside the courthouse. And earlier we had a similar discussion, and the council here can attest that we came up with some plans that we are planning to remove all receptacles from the roadway. One, it takes up a lot of time. It is looking ugly for our roadways. We think that the persons who placed them there weren't thinking in the first place. So there are plans of to remove all these because one
has the slips.
Yes, the slips. Yeah,
okay, that's right there.
That's where it's staging now. So everybody just take a bag right here. So there are plans in very short order they will be removed.
And just to say that's our experience right across the way.
Yes.
Once you have a skip on the name, all people just use it as an opportunity. The business people do it. Residents coming from where they put their garbage in the car, jump and they come. So it's easy for that skip because it's convenient for people. They pass it and they just use it. But we have earlier we spoke about the same thing and the people are going to come. And we said that we should probably look at finding space inside of the main where we can put these skips because they are abused by the passerby in a way, and especially by the commercial people.
Yes, a couple of concepts. Let's use Hanover.
Remember that this is not a solid based meeting.
No, I know. But we have an
agenda. But garbage is very important.
That it
needs to be dealt with.
My question.
Just go on over the way.
For this parish, how does one decide how many trucks we need for this parish? Is it that we sit down and we say we have 10 communities? And X amount of trucks will take care of X amount. Because if you're not looking along that line, you know, we're going to be having
seats. Let me just tell you straight.
Yes.
Well, that would tell us academically, that's some, very some. We have to cut the suit to match the cloth that we have. We don't have enough cloth to then decide the suit to wear.
Okay.
So what we have is a juggling for one another.
And we understand, however, If we continue to work like that, then we're going to be coming to meetings like this every year.
Which is why I pointed out earlier about some of the things we're doing differently. Look into a future that won't have these kind of meetings. Because if we get the transfer station working out, as it should be, two, one in Westmoreland and one in Trelawney, WPM would become, by those two acts, the cleanest place on earth. The other thing is, if we get people properly containerizing their garbage, if we get composting culture going, which I've outlined earlier, a lot of the complaints that we have now, first of all, 70% of what we take into our disposal site is composted. So you can imagine that all we will be, if we get the composting culture going the way we expect it to go, all we'll be moving is 30% of what we are moving now.
I need to finish here because I need to add something. Now, I know that no government can provide full employment. No government can provide all the jobs they need. I said that because I want to know if we are in a parish and you're able to provide us with two jobs based on your financial constraints, then if we can say, as a people, provide for the parish and an additional two jobs from private sources. And that's what we're doing. Because we have to help the government. We have to help ourselves. And I'm saying, if you can provide us with food based on the fund that you have, and we as a community, as a parish, can provide another tool based on people from abroad, we can make calls, we can come with funding, get an additional one, two trucks, then we'll be helping you and helping ourselves.
Well, let me tell you, before the meeting is done, let me tell you, make sure you get Garnet's number. And I'm going to instruct Garnet to work out with you what is the needs of Hanover and what we do have available in Hanover now. And you can feel free, also feel free to throw in, mobilize and throw in all the support you can. Because you know what? We need a hundred jobs, new jobs. We got 20 people. So you understand how far behind we are.
Okay, one last question. How do we deal with the private carriers? Because I noticed that the garbage trucks that are taking the garbage from the hotels, they tend to leave a couple of the bins on the roadside without any indicator on it. And for some reason, something is going to go wrong one day. I'm not certain whether or not you guys are responsible for them. You know, so we need to let them know that when they are moving garbage, and for some reason, I don't know if you pass it along the hotel stretch, they will just leave the
company. I know, the rollouts. Well, let me just address that frontal and tell you, the regulations, one of the three regulations that we have coming will help us, will empower us to deal with that. But that's also a choice matter. Just start a thing and leave it. And also a matter of the MC, the Municipal Corporation. But I'm saying this, that we believe that it's much of a nuisance that we factor that in crafting one of the regulations, or three pieces of regulation, and in one of them, we have in there the muscle to take care of that, because all over the place that we see happening, where they just leave the roll-offs and the roadway and in for their own convenience, and we will be dealing with it. Because rightfully, the NSWMA, the act, went formed, the spirit of the act was that we should be a regulator. And we have more into a corporational company. We will do more operation than anything. And part of the reason why is because we don't have the requisite regulation that should support the act that we could do things like that. But it's a very, very important observation. It's widespread. It's going to be in the new regulations coming out, we will be able to deal with that thing.
Yes.
While we have it good at the pain, once you start to ascend the lanes, is a challenge, something that we could more about, we want to look at, because in those areas, some of those areas, not even the trucks can't even reach out those areas. And he pointed out a couple of communities to me, which are like that. Composting would be good. 70% of water, we could make an arrangement for them to take it. They don't buy the available things to a particular point where we can access it, and then we could move it. But I take your point. Yes, ma'am.
And then you mentioned about education.
That is largely a private sector initiative all over the other jurisdiction. but in some jurisdictions we have the state doing a fair bit of recycling. We wouldn't want at this time, based on all the other factors that have outlined, to take that part as a project, but we encourage it and we partner with
we have to reach out to the
you want to compare?
And
we used to get that.
And reduce my garbage that I don't by 2/3.
Right, and we understand, we encourage that, we were big partners, and if we don't have the bigger of that fight, I must tell you. But we continue to encourage that, we do have a number of entities that are into recycling, and we open our disposal sites to them, we give them all the cooperation that they require, because we believe that that's where it should be. Government is supposed to be over everything, that's why we get into trouble all the time. We don't have the money, and we don't need it.
Recycling centers
starting
open again.
Good.
Recycling plant as well.
Shouldn't that be open?
Yes.
Go out there.
Are they coming to me?
You know, you have a second there, take it. They agree. I don't know why my daughter has to go on, because she's a little girl.
I was going to add to Ms. Drummond's point, you probably could set up a demonstration at the farmer's market, but there's one, a big one that lots of people don't really know, we could do with some education about composting. So you could have a demo there.
Yeah.
You see why the meeting is very important. Yes, my other friend. Thank you very much. There are any other questions?
Thank you, Mr.
Gordon. One suggestion. I urge you, when you're setting up the transfer station, to include in there a compost making section that resells the compost to the people.
Again?
Because, sorry, every place in the UK now has the transfer station has got a place like that. And they can sell the compost back to the public for their own particular use. I have to make really, really strong use of it.
That's a comment that I could never think of. Anything that will enhance or help us and help us to, you know.
But it's all money, isn't it? It's all money back into the internal fund.
Absolutely.
Isn't
it? Absolutely. Thank you very much.
Mr. Gordon, thank you very much.
Organizations in Lucea get involved
in the projects, because they are the people that will make sure that these projects are carried out competently, efficiently, and effectively. So the organization, which is, you have an organization, Claudia has an organization, and I would like them to get very involved in these projects about those outseas. All right, Mr. Mayor, we will outline the projects now that are and how far we've got with funding for it.
Good afternoon, everyone. As you just said, the two projects for Lucea. One is the Lucea Assad, and that project is presented with the TEF board. I have to understand that that was approved last week, Wednesday. The executive director of TEF is presented on that mission deal back on Friday, so he's going to need to sign off on it so it can be passed over to TPD. So as another project is the entrance sign to Lucea as well. That project in the amount of about $4 million was also approved for the so we are also awaiting the executive director of Hotel to sign off so we can get the funding and the TPD goes, then they will contact, then the TPD goes contact the municipal corporation for implementation. Entrance, I don't think it's the whole. What are the people in court? I don't even want the sign coming from into one to go away from Trelawney. Sign of welcome to St. James. That's sign of that nature. As some kind of who's entrance sign? The entrance sign.
Sign.
It's an entrance sign. It also involves landscaping activities around the area.
These developments, because they will take ownership of it and they will make sure it happens efficiently and effectively. Please, sir. So as soon as the project, Mr. Nair, will inform, we have the names of the groups that are here. So the president or the secretary or the manager of these groups, we will make sure, and this is the way to move forward, that they are involved in it.
As the age project, one more project, I heard Mr. Poole mention about the recycling project. Come September, I'm presently in dialogue with the recycling partners of Jamaica, which is a public-private partnership. Right? They are basically in some of the rolling out a recycling project in the schools. So I'm meeting with the Negril Chamber of Commerce and the recycling partners of Jamaica this Friday morning to discuss the way forward as it relates to how we're going to implement the project come September morning. We were at the plant in Negril, and the Negril Chamber of Commerce is presently doing some work to get it back up in a working mode so we can start the project as soon as possible. Alright, so what we want to talk, about say 20 schools in the initial phase, so it's good. So we expect that it will roll over into the home so we can see a better the packaging of the garbage as it relates to recycling. Alright, so our present challenge now is just to come. Just the collection of the aqua has to be itself taken to the plant in Israel. So in short order, we'll be contacting the municipal corporation to help the process. Alright.
And there's also in the work to enhance the aesthetics of Lucea. There's also not just the sign.
Yeah, I spoke about that as it relates to Lucea facade, because we have got a quote from Mr. Garner. He's something that I said to the King said from our view and about the
anybody has any question on that? Yes.
The recycling that's separate from
waste management?
Yes, separate from the fee.
The collection that is?
Yes, totally. The project was there first, and then it fell off because of the collection. So they had no people to go around to different parts of the mansion and also college. They were plastic blocks, glass, or the cardboard. So NCC, I don't know if you know, they are present with us. They own the property, so they are present with refurbishment to get the cardboard set up, and I know that they are doing a little collection and ready to plastic. Yes, ma'am?
Yes, I've heard the cardboard is the sign itself.
Yes, sir.
But there are a few things I was working on. Who's going to be now? The construction of the sign, the drawing of it, that would work.
Okay, I will get that. I myself don't know how it works. It's something before my time, but I will get a copy of it for you and publish it.
And the location?
Location, sir.
Alright, because if you don't want, if you are going to enter those, you want to share the Lucea.
It's Lucea, alright.
You know, if you start it, where the boundary is.
The wings that the wings were all the wings put out in Lucea, in the town. You know the wings, the Tikiniko wings, were they all put out in the town and around the Lucea area?
Yes, they were installed. But I can honestly tell you that there are some issues with them. Because we they were about to install this one and we are not. That is the worst I'm working on.
So
we saw what was done in the building and want to
leave.
There are few of those looking like that, and few are really going to be said, asked to take them on.
Right.
Doing just like they were.
So, Mr. Mayor, sir, wasn't it under your duty to make sure these signs, these bins were put in and put in properly or whoever? Wasn't it the duty?
I'm not saying that there is not put in properly.
Right.
We really have said to do it. We see that otherwise and a few different problems.
Okay. But then they should not have got paid.
Pardon?
They should not have got paid. Because it's not the way you wanted it.
I can tell you that no bill has reached us as yet.
Well, that's good. So they can still come back and put their property?
Yeah, they have to do it before they can actually get paid.
Okay. So we'll check on that to make sure that is done. So far, the ones that are done, are they being emptied, or they? You have somebody going around and they're
yes,
taking them and being bagged?
And
they're being bagged? Okay. And you have nobody dumping like fridges and things inside?
No.
As they are doing it. That's great. Right. Anybody has any more questions?
I just think I can ask Mr. Mary a question. The project that you called is just very long. I heard the second round of communication. Is that involved with what was promised to Lucea by the group?
Yes, that's what I mentioned about as it is in Lucea. Because remember, I had very first meeting with the mayor and I was full of one because I was and the executive director of them said it to me himself. That's how I got to do a follow up. And sent back our program that we have got from the municipal corporation for it to be revised.
But as far as I'm aware, I attended the meeting here and this around with me who
yes,
came
back.
I was part of
that's the same order.
And others, many others. And I was under the impression that what was said to us wasn't just a sign, it was making the area that comes into
yes,
it
but
more accessible.
Yes, I said the sign and I said the Lucea facade. That what you're speaking to now is in reference to the facade.
Yes.
Yes, so that we're going through it on the both entrances from Eclair and from Church Street.
Okay.
Yeah.
And
yes,
and does that involve what about Fort Charlotte?
No, I don't have anything about Fort Charlotte.
And those in here, there were
I have nothing thus far and Fort Charlotte. I know that there were some discussions before my time.
There was a very serious discussion to which the mayor was present and many others here was present and we were made promises not just having a talking session, we were made promises and nothing happened.
Mr. Dyer.
Mr.
Dyer.
Yes.
Mr. Godfrey Dyer made a commitment for Charlotte.
Yes.
To the tune of $34 million.
Was it in this budget year?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay. Well, we will follow.
Finish on that. And that was to actually carry out a proper feasibility study.
Yes.
I actually wrote an MOU on behalf of Lucea Development Initiative.
Right.
And I know that there was also a contract that was being drawn up. Now, it just all seems to have died. Where did that go to?
And his actual words were, it's about time something was done for Lucea. And that's my words, it's about time something is done for Lucea.
I mean, I just want to remind the meeting that the TEF spends nothing in Lucea.
Nothing.
At all. And never has done.
We've just passed over.
And yet, when you come to look at the number of hotel rooms, there are more hotel rooms in Hanover than there are in any other place. So why is all this money going to Trelawney all of a sudden to cater for people who are overnighting on a ship, basically, when we down this end are getting nothing? Just look at the state of our roads. I mean, there's a man trap out there, there's a tiger for it, and then again, it's still spikes in
there.
We will actually we'll report it to Secretary Smith and we will follow up on that.
I think it's fair to say what we'd like to see, we'd like to see a plan for Hanover, which is not forthcoming. The point to you, Mr. Murray, basically, is that the discussion that was going on a year ago. Almost a year ago now. And we have Gary Wallace down here, we have Dr. Spencer down here, we have Godfrey Dyer down here. Isn't that right, Mr. Mayor?
That is true, I like to speak on it.
And we were together in this room after a ride around the town to look to see what was going on. And here we are, almost 1 year later.
Do we have any minutes taken? Anybody took any?
I walked into the meeting, so I
right.
was down.
So
I was there.
So
you
were
there.
Apart from that, we had what I covered. Then said that. The last thing that we did was present a maintenance plan.
Right.
And that was good, right?
That's
right.
Yes. That's
the
reason.
Yes.
Oh,
yeah.
Yes.
That's all that he wanted. Because he wanted to ensure that when it's done and everything is designed and built and so forth,
right.
that it is maintained and it's quality. That was good. And
they will proceed.
I know, but we cannot. That's hearsay. If it's documented, we can say.
Oh, did he set up this so
Talking about the plan now for Hanover, the development plan. The municipal corporation should have something for that. Isn't that right, Mr. Mayor?
Planning is working.
Okay. Because I think the people or the organizations in Lucea would like to see it. Because I think it's only fair that they should have some input, people that are living here. It's only fair that they should have some input in how Hanover is going to be developed or Lucea town, etc.
Well, in collaboration with SDC, we need some of the money.
Right.
But what I want to speak on, though, mm-hmm. is the the entrance coming into Lucea. At that same meeting, and I think it was sometime in December 2017.
I heard it was December.
Right. We were told that Christmas.
It was
September.
Yes.
Christmas would not pass and we would get something.
Exactly.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Right.
We're going to do it for Christmas if we can.
Guaranteed.
We will have a wonderful Christmas.
Yes. Present.
As a present. And
right. So.
Nothing was done.
And
you have some high rated gentlemen there, some doctors in charge of UDC, I think. You know, that
yes, yes, yes.
The other group of people that were at that meeting was so high. So, you know.
maybe they were too high, so it didn't matter. Now I'll go to the roads with Janelle. Mr. Kitts from NWA, please could you give us some sort of update on the roads, especially in Lucea Town?
Well, for Lucea, the town of Lucea, we have some projects in the pipeline, but I'm not able to give you a definitive start of time. But we are going to be looking to patch certain areas along the seawall. We also have plans to repair gratings within the township itself, and also to replace two culverts in the town in the vicinity of the gas station and also by the tax office. And we also have a drain that should be cleared in the vicinity of Sheffield Hardware. So that's in terms of upcoming projects for the township.
Do you have any idea of the timeline, when?
No, I've not been given the project exception notice as yet, but these are areas that are being given priority. So probably within another couple of weeks, I'll be given the timeline.
Be careful with this couple of
weeks. Okay, let me rephrase. I have not been given a start time yet for these projects, but these are areas that we'll be looking into in terms of the roads.
Right. And the Lucea people anywhere else?
I have this mayor.
The mayor, sorry. Yes, please, the mayor.
I'm going to speak, Ash. I am really convinced that NWA don't have no intention at all to do any work within the town of Lucea. And the roadway from say Shoe Bridge to Negril. If you see the condition of those roads, the amount of potholes that we are going across and traversing it, you will realize and hear that these things are in the pipeline. I have heard these things before. When I came here in 2016, I heard that the great things out here would be fixed. They have it in the pipeline. And nothing has been done. And we are, I'm at this meeting now, and I'm hearing the same thing.
Yes,
I'm not hearing that it is going to start next week.
I totally agree with you, because I'm having the same problem. With agencies, we only get these promises, and we don't see any action. So,
not agencies, I'm speaking specifically about NWA. They are not doing one damn thing to this town. Excuse the language. They are not doing anything at all. And to know that even to think about the tourists, we're concerned about our citizens, but to think about how important Negril is to us.
Yes.
And the tourists having problems. I was coming from Negril the other night and right down by Abingdon, down by Janmar area, there's a pothole that always been there. And I saw a tourist come out in the middle of the night.
Alone
on the street because of a pothole that they hit and the tire blown out. We don't want that. We want to take care of these people when they come to us.
I understand, Mr. Mayor, because we're from the same immigrant, especially at the West End. I've seen it. Yeah. They fall in potholes in the lights.
We are having some issues again. We want to ensure that the traffic flow within the town. We came up with some arrangement. Some idea that we want to change this main road here,
right,
back into our
pool. Yes.
And the only thing that is holding them is the end of the day again. And we know that it can work.
Yeah. Janelle, can you also find out for us the timeline so we can circulate it to the mayor when these jobs are going to be done? We don't have them now, but we need.
As soon as they become available.
Chase. You need to chase them out and say the people. I mean, if we don't look after our people on the ground, and that is giving them roads, giving them water, giving them a clean environment, how do you think the people are going to breathe our forests? I mean, the tourist industry is very fragile as it is. I mean, we don't, and it's the people that make tourism what it is. The people, not the big hotels and all that, it's people. So we need to look after the people. They are number one.
Exactly.
And when we look after the people, they'll make sure our tourist industry thrive. And looking after them is giving them good roads. That's one of the decent things to do.
Okay, one of the tourist people.
That's the number one priority. Yes?
Yes. I just want to add just something to what Mia just said. There's a problem that we tried to put in the station. I can't
hear it.
And I'm feeling very bad coming to the municipal corporation meeting just before they did it like that.
Yes.
That one that I would not like to hear the
president try. Right. Can you make a note of that, please? Seems that could be addressed like ASAP.
Just outside the church here, my dear, performance by sticking out of it. And right from the stage, start the workshop in the corner.
Okay, then I'm sorry to hear that I mentioned earlier.
The lady, I'm sorry that you are the butt of the people, the love them, especially at my voice. I apologize to you, but something needs to be done. We can't be telling the people all the time, this, that, and the other is in running. We want a date for something that done.
Well, she's going to find the gate when these things are rather than in the pipeline, when they are coming up to the pipeline.
It's time something is done for Lucea.
Yes.
Because we spent, Madam Chairman, please.
Sorry. Yes.
I've been waiting for this meeting for a long time.
Yes.
Yes. We spend money here in Lucea. A lot of people spend money here. And we are people too. And something needs to be done for the people in Lucea. One project, just do one project so we can say, yes, something has been done.
We know, we are working on it. We are working on it to make sure that the people see that something is being done. Because it's all part of the tourist industry and we need to make sure that the people see something.
I've said it before, Elaine, and I'll say it again, and I'll keep on saying it. The same people that turn up every day, 6 days a week, to go to a hotel and serve tourists looking crisp and fresh and however else it is, they're the same people who are not getting the service from the government.
That's deliberately
spending money elsewhere. And we need some spent in Hanover,
yes.
And we need it spent right now.
Yeah.
Right now. We need the roads fixed, especially within the town itself. It's an absolute disgrace. Driving through Lucea is like driving through a war zone.
Thanks, John. I think John wants to say something.
I want to say something about Negril, but I just want to mention, I've been coming driving through for years now, the grating on the one way.
Exactly.
Thank you.
It's been years.
Yeah.
No, it's a disgrace.
Years. It's been years. I cannot believe that this is that.
It's a disgrace.
Do you know what happens with the NWA? They could do a patch job. They've just done one outside where I live.
Oh, sorry. Can you get
and then
John,
you've got 6 months
to
find the
I just want to mention that before I mention the medians in the village. I know that I have someone here that they're research and find out what's going on with them, because people keep running into them, it's a danger. We're either going to highlight them or remove them. They need to do something with those media.
Yes.
They're just not safe. I see here it was mentioned that they're going to conduct some sort of research and just find out if they're necessary or not. At the moment they're not necessary, you've got to highlight them or remove them because they're dangerous. Cars are running into them.
Yeah.
Thanks, John.
Thank you.
We're going to need Janelle to answer that.
With all due respect, at the end of the day, my question is there an option to getting the roads fixed that does not include the NWA?
I wish we would. I think there could be, but you would have to go around again to search. I don't know. NWA is an agency of government.
Right.
They get grants from government to do roads.
I understand that, but it seems to me that our dependence on government handicaps us.
Yes.
So I was wondering if there is an alternative so that when government fails to satisfy the people's needs, that the municipality has an alternative.
Right. Well, I can just tell the mayor.
The trouble with that is the NWA are granted funds from provincial government to do those jobs. So if you go somewhere else, you need another funding source.
Well, just
because the government money is going to NWA.
Right, just to point out to the mayor that I got a call from Mr. Bertelmore about assisting him to get some funds to do some inner roads. Now, the CEO of TPD said he didn't need our assistance. All he has to do is apply. They have a grant going, I think it's for 20 million to do roads to attractions.
Okay.
That's going, and you can apply through those, through that, roads to attraction. This money has been put aside to do roads to attractions.
That's
so you could apply. The municipal corporation could apply to that, roads to attractions fund. Right, and then, yes, and then just apply for some funds, identify the roads we need to get this. Not the main roads. Right, because NWA, I mean, you can do it as well, so.
Okay, you see, my major concern is that destination assurance means that we have to do everything to ensure that we assure the destination.
The guest, right.
And to what is happening now, I don't want Hanover and the municipal corporation to take any blame for not being able to assure this destination. Because if the streets of Lucea, the roads of Lucea, and the parish itself is not fixed, we are going to have a breakdown. And I don't want to make it clear to me that we are not here to take any blame for what is happening.
Right.
We are playing our role. When we go here and we want some assistance from NWA to get these roads fixed or to change roads so that tourists can traverse easily.
Right.
They are refusing. It means that we cannot do anything, we cannot touch their roads. If it was a local program, we wouldn't give any permission for it to be fixed. We can't touch NWA road.
I know.
They will not allow that.
No, I'm glad you said it's not on any part of the municipal corporation. Because one of our challenges as the DAC council, that we are not really getting the buy-in of the agency to make these destinations become assured. And we are saying, and I mean, on my part, I was just saying, it's the municipal corporation that are not giving us the assistance to make sure the destinations are safe for our visitors and the people, not just visitors, and the people. Because as I said, it's the people that make the tourism products work. And we need to look after them first. So I am glad to hear you say that we will have all the cooperation from your municipal council. Thank you for that.
Okay.
Any other questions?
It might be useful. We had a meeting last week for the first time where all the DACs came together for the first time. So we were about a year in or something like that. In this time. And actually, one of the main points, common points from the different DACs, was the struggle, the challenge of engaging the national agencies that we're all dependent on to make this concept work. So we put that squarely back to the minister. And he was hearing it from, I think, 5 out of the 6 DACs. That one of the biggest problems we've got is. Actually, although we're relying locally on agencies people who are representing agencies here today, there also needs to be buy-in at the very top of those agencies, and that has to filter down and make sure those things happen. So one of the main action points that came out of that meeting was that TPDCO are going to start that process or refresh that process of getting hold of people at the top of agencies and saying, we need your cooperation to make this work. So we're hopeful that will spark something. And we did see Mr. Gordon here today, so maybe that's maybe something filtering down. But we need it from people like the NWA. We need answers. We need to have the local people empowered enough to be able to say, not have to keep saying to us, we're going to do this, this, and this, but we don't know when. We need to get a message across, and I think from this meeting, we definitely want to take something back to the NWA about the lack of any action here. And I think, Mr. Ross, that goes back to your point that,
alternative.
Is there an alternative?
Right.
You get to a point where you give the NWA enough chances and maybe then you do think about alternative. And in fact, on a small scale, it did happen in the room recently.
Yeah.
The patching of the West End wasn't done by NWA.
Yes.
Right.
And so the minister did say that we should see things happening with the agencies in the next few weeks, because I don't know if he's going to do whatever to make these agencies comply to the wishes of the DAC. So we'll hopefully see something happen.
Just to kind of concretize something that the mayor said, you know, some of the polls that we see in town, and it's very, very easy for people to say the mayor, the mayor, the council are not doing their work.
Right.
In fact, there's certain things out there we can't touch. Because if we go here and do something, people can sue us.
Right.
Why they can't sue that organization? They can sue us as an individual because we're not supposed to touch it.
Right.
But for God's sake, if some small holes we see there, even a couple of bag of patch, just throw it. Because you can't have something 3 feet by 3 feet causing a guest to lose his or her life.
Yeah.
Come on, give me a break. And if you said to us, okay, said to us as a council, like, listen, it is not the purview of the council to do that. But here are some patches. And if these things happen, yeah, then it's said at the top. Those patches are for us in the kingdom. We try and help. But it can't be that nothing, just for months, for years. You know what I had to do the other day? I had to get a friend of mine, put some marl in the trunk. And I'm like, full steak, because I'm like, you grow there.
Yeah.
A massive wall. I had to put there myself one night and to use my shovel as a counselor and put it in a hole there, because I'm certain if it, I might be coming on the other side, somebody swing from and kill me.
Yeah.
One down here now?
Yeah, exactly. It must be the one that I put some marl in and then after a while you go. But come on, we need to have this level of cohesiveness. And I'm not going to be taking anyone blame. When I have my job to do, I will take my blame when it's my time.
Right.
But I'm not going to be taking blame for an organization who is doing their work.
Right. Thank you, sir. Janelle, I would just like to ask, about 2 months ago, when we had our last meeting, you told us, because there's a program for NWA to do island-wide patching. And you told us in that meeting, in 2 weeks, and this is about 4 or 3 months ago, when we had our last meeting, you said, we will be seeing it in 2 weeks. That's why I told you be careful of the 2 weeks. And we have seen nothing yet. I saw you started some on the Montego Bay, coming out to as far as, I think, Half Moon. And then there is nothing. Hopewell is a disgrace. Coming through there.
Yes.
I mean, it's Sandy Bay is a disgrace.
Yes.
And coming through, nothing. And you have money to do island-wide patching. What's happening to it, please? Can you tell me?
That's still on the book, but we're having a challenge in many instances in
terms of procuring material, in terms of what's happening in terms of getting the bitumen. So that is a large part of the problem.
But that happened before Petrodam. That's when you told
No, me. But it is something.
So that's another excuse.
No, it's not an excuse. It's a challenge that we have been facing on and off for several months now in terms of getting sufficient bitumen to continue with these programs.
So do you have any idea when this program will continue so we could see, physically see something happening with these?
I don't want to give a definitive timeline.
Well, you know, I've been here for 2 weeks and I'm still waiting. Please, Janelle, can you take that back to your powers that we need to see some action? Have we got anybody here from security?
Superintendent, because we are still awaiting your VCs, because we brought that up to Mr. McCoy every time, nothing so far.
It's more as public as well as our facility department. So they are supposed to get back to you by the end of this week as it relates to going forward for the EC. I know that they said they should be doing more training in the short term. Hanover is on the transition. Not the Hanover transition,
Hanover will be. Hanover will be, because I put that in a few months now.
Yes, because
I remember when you, yes, right. I put that in that they are requesting some DCs on Hanover. So hopefully that should. Anybody here from Water Commission?
Cheers.
Cheers. Sir.
Just
to speak. Oh, sorry. Just let
me. Just to speak a little bit, please. Yeah. It is really sad that you know the treatment that Hanover is getting is not good. I'm not advocating for Hanover's first aid.
I know.
But the treatment is so bad. Because here we are now. Hanover, the neighboring part of Hanover that have the better hotels. Right? We don't have any DC. The other end of it in Westmoreland. Have a lot of DCs down here.
I know, that was why I requested that the superintendent was there. When I requested, this must be one. 6 months, 7 months,
about that.
I requested that some be in Hanover, they promised they won't.
So, who do we speak to, Alice?
Well, it was Mr. Morris.
It's Morris, the first one in charge of the program. So, as I said, he said, by this week, we should see him in some confirmation as to when they will be posted here.
Because I bring them up.
Can
they
be reported for us?
Before.
Can I be the reported for us?
No, the media is here to highlight good work. Good work that we are supposed to be doing, sir. Together.
Okay, so this is this is a good work.
When they will be dispatched here, or when they will be doing the recruitment? Because you'll be looking at persons from within these areas.
Right. I think the timeline for when they will be the recruitment and dispatch.
Okay.
So I'll speak more about it. When I'm here, I'm going to call him and call him, as well as discussing the person.
Yeah. And we were also promised some motorcycles. So bicycles, that is.
All right.
Okay.
Well, maybe it's another department. I think it's from the US side. US.
Okay. Because we've been waiting on some ATVs as well from the beach.
And right.
We don't know when they are coming. I think they are here.
ATVs
are
here.
Yes. Okay. But there have been problems appearing there. Water Commission, sir. Yes. Have you got anything to report to us? Good news?
Not really. Nothing to report.
Well, there might be a few people that here that would ask me some questions.
No problem. Sure.
Anybody having any water issues? The man is here.
First of all, through the chair.
Yes, sir.
I realize that over time, we're going to be changing our iron pipes. And I know that when you dig the road to fix your car, you can't fix it as it have to watch to see if the pipe is going to burst again. But it is still too long a time to have your own fixed. And I know you're trying, but I'm wondering as to whether or not you're going to see some improvement. Because what I do not want is to put you in the same pot as my good friend, NWA. Right? But it can't be. I see one right at the corner here, in front of the church,
right,
and has
right.
been here for months.
Right?
Right? It's another thing we can't touch as a council. Right. But we still get the blame as well, as councillors. Right? So you've got to help us so that as soon as possible, as you, you can fix it fast, so we don't get the type of blame that's heading our way. I know you can't stop the pipe from bursting. I know the old pipes now has been there for years, and you love to change them over the cart. But I'm asking, please, in terms of fixing them, could you do that as quickly as possible? That's all I ask.
Okay.
Thank
you, sir. For the road course, what is your known at the table? So we have a tire up here to leave. We now have to send the measurements to end of the game. And once the piece of the
it is not an automatic process, so I don't agree when Water Commission makes it seem that, you know, it's an automatic that you go and you put one hole right in front of the police station and the communication is immediate that you're ready for it to be fixed. And we agree, for us to fix as part of our MOU, there has to be a they cannot go out independently and patch any works that the Water Commission has dug up, any error. So we have to agree and we have to get the go-ahead from the Water Commission before. So it's not an automatic process, and it's not that the Water Commission is sending over the information and we are deliberately not patching the error.
And it's a process too?
It is a process.
Yes. So sometimes it becomes
but that's my question. Is there a coordination between your agency and roadworks?
There's an understanding.
No, we're not talking about understanding. If we're not going to dig a hole to fix a pipe in 2 months, is it that in a make roadworks knows we're not going to dig a hole in 2 months and we need it for compatriot?
We've got an MOU.
Yes.
It doesn't work.
It's not work.
So we need to do something else. Take it to Bo, Mr. Rossi's idea, and get someone else to fix the road if they want to.
And remember, it's not about the agency, it's about the people where you serve.
I don't want it to be a rephrase. It's not a case that we choose not to be the voter.
So we'll have to clarify that with Mr. Warnick and the other members. What is happening? Anybody else have anything with water commissions?
This is a difference.
Sorry,
Chair.
Yes.
I would like to know when one of our children, or the elder person like myself, Danny Massa, who am I told?
The municipal
company. No, no.
You can't see them most of the places now. How can you get people to walk across the road and use them when they can't see the things?
You know something, Mr. Rossa? That could be done as a Labour Day project.
It was proposed to be done as a Labour Day project. I proposed it, and NWA wouldn't allow it.
Right, they wouldn't allow it.
No.
The Municipal Corporation can ask.
Yeah, what I would suggest that the DAC, that's what we call it.
Yes, Destination Assurance.
Right, is to write to the Municipal Corporation and outline this concern about the signs, the marketing, the streets and so on.
Right.
And we will go in and take it on, I can assure you that people. That is what I can assure you.
Alright. So we will write to you and try and get those
done. That seems for
right, because a lot of things, you know, we need to help ourselves as well. And we have lots of groups, and we can go out to raise, have some people, and we can actually do a Labor Day project or a community project. And we can do lots of things to help ourselves. So sometimes we don't have to rely on government, because we just heard how long and old the process is. So we cannot just sit down and because we have to work together for the benefit of our country and our people.
If I recall the name, prior to the last Labour Day, the NWA actually nationally put out a notice to say that groups should not be repainting the roadways because it was not within general public's remit to do it. It was an NWA project.
Now look at Lucy. Just look at the one outside Brussels. You don't know whether they're trying to cross the road or what they're trying to do.
I know.
And the one just back here,
just in front of the police station. And the police station as well.
So now, please, can you put in with your patchy, which is coming on stream hopefully in 2 weeks or so, could you put in that we rehabilitate all the road crossings and things as well, please? All right, thank you. Anything else? If not, we'll do the meeting. Can we adjourn the meeting then? Oh, sorry. Sorry, I
would just like to say congratulations to General.
Yes,
she has stood her ground. Congratulations.
Yes. Thank you. I think they are going to give you an award. There's nothing else. Thank you all for coming, and I hope it has been a very successful and fruitful meeting. Our next meeting is in 3 months, I think it will be September, around that time. And the hope, and maybe in Negril, and we hope to have another meeting here. Again?
Thank you.